जय गुरुदेव। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, चिल्ड्रन, यू नो वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 3, फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। एंड अंडर दिस चैप्टर इन द ऑनलाइन क्लास आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू अबाउट द नेचुरल एंड मैनमेड फाइबर्स और आर्टिफिशियल फाइबर्स। ओके, एंड इन दिस चैप्टर जनरली we are studying about the animal fibers, because plant fibers we have already studied in class 6. So under the animal fibers we will study about mainly the wool, and you know wool we obtain from hair of various animals, in which I have explained you about the sheep in detail and how we get this fiber from sheep. And in this I explained you about the merino sheep, about this picture related to this sheep, and it is a good variety and special breed which gives us large quantity of wool. And after this, how we follow the process of rearing of sheep, and what are the different varieties in our country. In all over the world also, we have studied in this previous part that Australia, China and United States, these are the main producers of wool. But other than this, these countries, if we talk about our India, India also has different breeds of sheep, which is given here in this table. And in this they have written the name of different breeds of sheep and what quality wool we get from those sheep, that about that they mentioned here. So first breed of sheep is Lohi. It gives us good quality wool, but from this kind of wool we can make carpets and blankets, these kind of things. And second breed is Nali. This Nali breed is also good quality, gives us good quality wool, and it is also used mainly for making carpets. And third breed is Rampur Bhushair, and it has brown fleece. Fleece means when we shave off the hair of sheep and we collect in the form of bundles, then that bundle of their hair means in large amount we call it as a fleece. So it gives us brown fleece, brown hair. And next breed of sheep is Marwadi. So Marwadi sheep gave us coarse wool. Coarse means hard or harsh kind of wool. So it is also used to make carpets. But only children, here you can see Bhakarwal. This breed of sheep only gave us better quality wool, which is used to make woolen shawls and woolen sweaters and other materials which are made up of wool. So these all are the Indian breed of sheep and their quality they have written here, and what kind of products we can prepare from them. So after this, now some other animals are also there. Like I have told you, Many animals are there which provide us wool other than sheep. So about other animals, first is goats. Goats also gave us wool. So the wool fibers derived from goats include mohair from Angora goats and Kashmiri from several types of goats. So children, here two variety of wool we get from different types of different breeds of goat. One is mohair and second is Kashmiri. So mohair is a best quality wool which we get from Angora goat, and Kashmiri we get from some other types of goats. And various types of products also we can make from these kind of these variety of wool, like mohair and Kashmiri, like shawls, sweaters, gloves, scarves, and many other kind of clothing material which we generally use in winter season. So next animal is camels. Camels, you know children, these are the animals which generally found in the desert area, and the wool fibers obtained from certain camels such as llama and alpaca are very soft, warm, lightweight and lustrous. So camel also provide us wool, but some variety of camel are also mentioned here, llama and alpaca. These two variety of camels are there which provide us large amount of wool, and that wool is soft, warm, light in weight and lustrous. Lustrous means shiny also. Okay, so that's why their wool is generally used to prepare, manufacture different variety of clothing materials. So the best quality wool is obtained from Bactrian camel, which have two humps and are found in Mongolia and China. So children, in your book also this animal picture is given. You can see here, this is the picture of Angora goat which provide us mohair wool. I told you, see how it is, its body is fully covered with thick hairy structure, and these hair are good for the manufacturing of shawls. So this is Bactrian camel and it has two humps. You can see here, these are the humps, and generally you know humps of camel are there. Under these humps camel store fats, okay, so that they can survive without food for several days, food and water. So this is the variety of camel which has two humps. Generally camel has a single hump, but it has two humps, and it has some soft or shiny kind of wool which we get from this Bactrian camel. Okay, so this is the picture of this breed of camel. And after this, next animal is rabbit. So So angora wool is obtained from the angora rabbit. So children, don't confuse in this. Here we are talking about angora wool, but in the first paragraph we talk about the mohair wool, which we get from angora goat. This is a variety of goat and mohair is a kind of wool. Okay, but here angora is a kind of wool which we obtain from angora rabbit. Okay, so this is also special kind of wool. This wool is fluffy, soft and of good quality. So rabbits are also important because many breed of rabbit also give us quality wool. And this last animal, which is called yak, you know, it is situated generally in the snowy areas, mountainous areas. So yak reared in Tibet and Ladakh also yield wool. Means some variety, some breed of yak also provide us wool, and that wool is also used for making carpets, blankets, some other kinds of jackets, and for stuffing purposes we use that. So that was the study about the different animals which provide us wool. So now we are talking about the processing of wool, means how we get that wool and how that wool converted into fabric. So the steps involved in the processing of wool are shearing, scouring, sorting, cleaning of burrs, and last is dyeing, means coloring. So these all the processes we will study, read and explain one by one. So first of all is shearing. So the process of removal of woolen fleece of a sheep is called shearing. So children, their hair, you can see this person is removing or shaving of the fleece of sheep. So the process of removing the fleece means large amount of hair when we take out from the animal body with the help of shears are the tools with the help of that we shave off the hair of sheep. So that this process is called as shearing. So this is usually done manually with scissors, hand blades or with special clippers. So children, different people, they adapt this kind of process. They generally use scissors, hand blades or some special kind of clippers for shearing purpose. Okay, so if they follow this process manually to keep the animal safe during the process, shearing should be done as kindly and gently as possible with proper care for the animal's well-being. Means it should be kept in mind that we should not harm the animal, or animal will not get any kind of problem when we remove their hair. Okay, so that's why we should take care with the proper skill, so that animal will not get any kind of harm during shearing process. The shearing becomes as easy as humans getting a haircut. Okay, so it is an easy process, but there is a thick fleece of hair, so that's why it will take little bit manual labor. So also it helps the sheep by removing excess hair that they do not need in the summer. Means that it also helps when we shear the animal, or when we follow the process of shearing of sheep, it helps the animal to remove the excess hair which they don't want during summer season, because this much thick hair, if it remains on the body during summer season, then they may feel so hot during summer, so they don't need these hair during summer. And we should keep in mind that we should remove their hair before summer season, so that up till winter hair can come again, hair can grow again. So second process is scouring. So the sheared hair is washed in tanks or in a special machines thoroughly to remove dirt, dust and grease. Means whatever waste is stuck there on their hair, that all the things removed by washing their hair into tanks. Okay, so all the waste material removed by this process. So the process by which raw wool from the animal is cleaned to eliminate impurities is called scouring. Okay, so it is the process mainly to remove all the impurities from the wool, that's why it is called scouring. The wool is then passed through rollers and dryers. So after this scouring, wool passed to the through the dryers so that it will dry up, and they roll by passing through the rollers. Okay, so after this, you can see here this is shearing, and here they are doing the scouring by putting into water tank. And scouring, last process of scouring they have given here, means they passed through the dryers, and after that they passed through the rollers to roll into yarn. Okay, so after this, third process is sorting or grading. Sorting means to sort out the different types of hair. So sorting consists of separating hair according to color and length. Means according to the length or according to the color of different hair, we sort out different variety of, means different kind of hair separately, so that we can send for making different products from them. Fourth is removing burr. Small furry fibers called burrs are picked out from the hair. So these are the kind of small fibers which are fluffy in nature, and they are called burr, and they are removed, or we can say separated from the main hair, long hair. So that's why this is the fourth process. And last process is dyeing, means to color these hair. The fibers can be dyed into different colors. As the natural fleece of sheep and goat is black, brown or white. So natural color is black, brown or white, but we can dye them, we can color them according to us. Differently we can color, and after that we can use for spinning, weaving and finishing. Means the fibers are straightened, combed and then rolled into yarns. The longer ones are spun into wool for making woolen garments, and the shorter ones are woven into woolen clothes. Okay, so means two kind of fibers or hair we sorted out now. One are the long hair and second are the shorter hairs. So longer hairs are spun into wool, which are generally used to make woolen garments. Okay, like gloves, sweaters or scarves, shawls, all these things. And the shorter ones are woven into woolen clothes. So shorter ones are also woven into woolen clothes. Means we can prepare yarn from it and then we can make woolen clothes. So children, this is about the process by which we can get, how we can get wool from the animal and how it will converted into fabrics, or we can say garments. Okay, so whatever I have taught you today, you just revise it and try to understand the process and learn all these steps. These are very important steps, and these you learn thoroughly. Okay, so for today, I conclude my class here. In the next class, we will talk about another animal which provide us wool. So, Jai Gurudev.